But across China, pretty much everything has some sort of meaning which we have to start trying to learn a little bit about. Just a little bit of awareness goes a long way. We talked about the business cards and presenting it with two hands. Across China, I think there's four in mainland China and one in Taiwan, there are these pine trees which look a little bit like this. I think this one is in Huang Mountain. What it looks like is a pine growing straight represents a man of nobility and of honor and intellect and high character, but also has this branch coming out offering forward two hands, just like you'd be doing with a business card or a brochure or with your passport. And that actually looks like something of nobility showing mutual respect. You don't have to explain this to Chinese people. They see it and go, they don't even say, and we know it. It's just they know it. The same thing happens with things like bamboo. Bamboo represents something which is grows straight, but also offers flexibility as well, especially flexibility in hard times. You don't have to explain it. It's there. This image here is one of the Chinese sages, an old man, a bald, high forehead, often surrounded by, accompanied by children, and sometimes shown he's accompanied by deer. So, strangely, he's a bit like Father Christmas in a way. He rides deer across the sky and likes children. But he's actually the sage of longevity. And the thing he's most accompanied by is a peach, because peaches also represent longevity. So if you're a Chinese insurance company, your brochure or your website might have lots of pictures of peaches on it. Now, we would look at it and go, because it's tasty and fuzzy? I don't know. It's totally lost on us. But for a Chinese audience, you wouldn't have to explain it. It's there, it's understood, it's accepted, and it's appropriate and relevant. Other issues which come up, the Great Wall. It represents national unity. And this is why some of China's major companies, Great Wall Wine, Great Wall Motors, for example, they are Great Wall Cigarettes. They are the main big Chinese companies. And as a foreign company, it wouldn't be appropriate, but you certainly wouldn't even be allowed to call yourself Great Wall Automation Company from Belfast. No, you wouldn't be allowed. It really shows it's China's own identity. Lots of images, of course, in China related to the Communist Party. And when you sometimes, I've been into see companies since I left working in China and came back from the UK, some taking out delegations and visits to China. And I can walk into a company and you'll see imagery of the Communist Party on plaques or business licenses when you walk through the foyer of a company. And you know the links between that company and the Communist Party and the local government. For most other people, it's lost. And you just think, oh, who is this company? Where do they fit into local government? But you can spot these things if you know what the symbols of government are. And then we have the absolute wonderful thing of who you are as a person. Which year were you born in? Now, I did actually see, you know, Russell Grant, the astrologer. I saw him at Euston Station a couple of weeks ago. He's looking well. Chinese people don't think of it as a bit of fun and games of, I'm a Cancerian. I'm going to have an interesting day today, but work hard and it'll all be okay. No, this is really quite a serious issue. Who you are is your character, and most of it is determined by which year you were born in. A lot of these things are positive, but there are interactions between people of different years. So you may often hear the Chinese people ask you how old you are. They're not asking you how old you are to find out how old you are. They can have a guess at that by looking at you. What they want to work out from that is they find it a bit weird to ask you, because if you're Chinese, they would ask you, what year are you born in? Or, you know, what animal are you? But for us Westerners, they know that's just too weird a question. So they ask us how old we are, and then from how old we are, they know which year we were born in, and then they know which animal we are. And then they have an idea of what our character is like. You've also got these modern interplays of things like, then, which blood type are you? Yeah. When I first started working for a Taiwanese company, I was asked for, obviously, the year and date of my birth and what time of day it was as well. And that was information was then taken by my boss, given to his mother, who then went to the temple just to make sure I was the right sort of person to be able to work with her son who owned the company, that we would actually be good work business partners working together. It came out okay. It was all right. So people do take this seriously.